Hey guys, I am your mad scientist. Some of you know me as Mrs. Holler, some of you know me as Miss Alexander or Miss A, some of you know me as Libby, some of you don't know me as anything yet. So, hey, I am going to be trying to post lots of different fun science experiments. Some of them you can try at home, some of them I might think twice about trying at home. This one is one that you could absolutely try at home. You probably don't have an Erlenmeyer flask at home, but you might have like a Starbucks Frappuccino bottle or anything with a more narrow top and an egg. So, here we go. So, this is my friend Egbert. Yes, his name is Egbert. And this is his room, his bedroom. This is where he's got all his video games and whatnot. The problem is, on this social distancing thing, where he's forced to stay home, can't hang out with his friends, well, he's eaten all the snacks that his family got that was supposed to last them like 3 weeks. He ate them all in like 2 days. So now Egbert does not fit through the door to his room. Oh my God. What are we going to do? Egbert wants to go in his room. He wants to play Fortnite. Okay, what should we do? Well, I have a solution for Egbert, and it involves fire. So fire needs three things in order to burn. Something to burn, so a fuel source. It needs oxygen, and it needs a spark. Well, I have a spark. I have oxygen. And I have something to burn. Now, I want you to think for a second. If you don't have enough oxygen getting to your lungs, what do you do? You try to take a deeper breath. Well, fire, even though it's not alive, actually does the same exact thing. It's gonna try to take a deep breath and it creates a vacuum to try to suck in as much oxygen as it possibly can. So I'm gonna hope that the fire is gonna make enough of a vacuum to suck Egbert into his room. Let's try it. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna light a little piece of paper on fire. Maybe don't do this yourself. Maybe have somebody else do this. Drop it on in there, and I'm gonna put Egbert right on top in his doorway. And as that fire needs more oxygen, it's gonna start to suck Egbert in. Go Egbert, it's your bedroom. Go Egbert, it's your bedroom. You can do it. Well, it took Egbert's clothes off, but the rest of Egbert made it in. My egg was a little too big. But the rest of Egbert made it in, just not his shirt. We'll pretend his shirt came off there. All right, now, here's our next problem. Now that Egbert's in there, his mom just bought more snacks, and so he wants to come out of his room to get those snacks, but it would appear that he's now stuck inside of his room. I can't light anything on fire to suck him out this way, so what am I gonna do? How am I gonna get Egbert back out of his room? This is where a little pressure comes into play. Because if I go like this, I'm just gonna give Egbert a headache. Egbert's just gonna get a headache that way. So instead, I'm gonna put as much air into this flask as I possibly can, I'm sorry, into Egbert's room as I possibly can. And once the pressure builds up, my breath is not strong enough to break the glass, but it will push Egbert right back out of his room. And his sister's calling him anyway. Her name is Meg. Get it? Here he comes. Come on, Egbert. Come on, Egbert. It's a very slow process. Keep going, Egbert. You're almost out. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There he is. Now he can go get snacks. Maybe he should wash his hands first. He's a little dirty. So that was my first video. I hope you enjoyed it. I will be posting jokes. I will be posting more experiment videos, but hope you enjoyed it.